And welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and we are going to be delving farther into the math skills to ace chemistry. Today we're going to be looking at logarithms. So with logarithms, whenever we hear that term, it can be very daunting, especially if you've had it in basic algebra. You might have realized like, oh, you did not maybe have a good experience the first time. But really what is all about is that it's a lot easier of a concept than you realize. Is that logarithms, what they are, so log for short, we're not talking about the piece of wood here, but when it comes to logs or a logarithm, is that these are math functions. And now with that function, what it does is it tells you how many times the base is multiplied by itself to reach that number. So what do I mean by that to kind of make that make a little bit more sense? So most of the time in chemistry, we're using a log 10 function. So this is referred to as the base. Now, in order to make this operation make sense, we have this 1000 number here. So we are going to use the log to take the function, and we want to know how many times does 10 fit in this number. So if you think about that, right, you do 10 times 10, that's 100, times 10 again, and that is 1000. It went into that three times to see how many times does the base fit. So the answer would be 3. So that's kind of the idea here, is that we're trying to figure out, well, can we make a simpler system? So how is that exactly used in chemistry? Let's take a look. In chemistry, it's very common that we use scientific notation to denote different scales. And the general reason why we use that is because it helps simplify a lot of the numbers we use. So one thing is, though, we commonly use a negative log base scale to determine how acidic or how basic a substance is, which is known as pH, right? You use pH in chemistry and biology and environmental science, you use it all the time. So with the pH, all it is equals to the negative log, and we're taking the function of the concentration of the acid. So what we do is we plug in the molarity of H plus into the log function, and we will get a pH. And we can do the same thing for pOH as well. Now, the point of this video is not to talk about pH and the concepts behind it. That's another video, which I would recommend referring to. But we are just going to look at the math and how to use your calculator to do log functions. Let's go into this a little bit farther, which calculator you're used to. So we're going to be using a TI-36X Pro, so Texas Instrument calculator. And I'll also be giving tips and tricks on like the TI-83 and the TI-88, which are other calculators which are very similar as well. So what we'll be doing is we'll be showing my calculator display here. So I'll be kind of showing you the different buttons to hit, so that way you can get an idea of exactly what this guy looks like. So that way you can follow along with your calculator. And I would recommend trying to practice it along with me. So that way you can see, are you entering them in right? Because you don't want to do all the work and then put the wrong answer on an exam, even though you knew how to do it. It's just discouraging and not fun. So let's go forward and take a look at some examples of this. So with our first example, we're going to find the negative log of the following numbers. And we're going to also be determining our sig figs. So the first thing is let's talk about the sig figs. So when we are doing these, sig figs are a little different when it's talking about logs. So the whole idea is you count the number of sig figs you have, and that's going to represent how many decimal places you have in your pH value. So we have 3 on the left-hand side, so that means you're going to have 3 decimals on this pH. So if we were to do this, so let's bring up our calculator to solve this. The first thing is how do we end up using it? So the first thing is hitting our negative button. So that way we make sure that we do use a negative log. Now the log button is up here on the top left-hand side of your calculator. So you can kind of see the log button here. And one thing about it is you'll notice that there's 2 different things listed. You have ln and log. So if I hit that one time, that is a log, but it's not the right one. This is wrong. This is a natural log. We use this for different algebra applications and for more advanced chemistry purposes. So what we would do is we got to hit the button one more time, and then the log will pop up. So you want to make sure you check. Now, if you accidentally hit it too many times and this pops up, what this allows you to do is you can actually define your base value, which for us is 10. But the last one that was previously up here was the exact same thing. So if you just hit it again, it will pop up the negative log. Okay. So now the whole idea is we're going to plug in our numbers. So we have 1.00, right? And then we would do times 10. And we're going to raise that using our power function right here to the negative fourth. So we hit negative again, hit four. We want to move our cursor over so we can end the parentheses, right? You want to use parentheses as much as you can. So now we have the following value. You want to check. We see that everything's plugged in, right? You don't want to blindly just start plugging and chugging numbers and not understand them, right? So when we hit equal, we'll get four, which makes sense. It tells you what the power is when this is equal to its regular value. So we have four and we want three decimals. So it'd be 4.0000, which would represent our theoretical pH if we had a concentration of H plus. So let's go to the next one and do another. So I have 0.00001. So if I were to do this, we're gonna do the same idea. So we still hit that negative log. We'll make sure the LOG pops up. And now we will plug in our values. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros, then one. So we wanna just double check that we have everything. End parentheses, hit equals, and we'll have our value. So this tells you that that decimal place moved over six times, which is what our pH is. Being that we had a total of one decimal place, or sorry, one sig fig, that means we're going to have one decimal place with our number, so 6.0. All right, for the next one, one thing we can see here is that we have two sig figs, so that means we'll have two decimal places. So when we do this, so we'll clear our work, we have negative log again, we'll make sure we have the LOG, now we'll put in 5.0, we'll times that by 10 to the negative 7, make sure everything plugs in, everything looks fine. Now we're going to hit end our parentheses and we'll hit enter. And now this is when it starts to be values that go between pHs. You can have values between because acidity is a range, right? It goes from 0 to 14 typically. So being that we had two, we're going to want two decimal places. So we'll put 6 and then we'll put 3, 0, and we're going to be rounding here. We see it's next to a 1. So we keep it just where it is. All right, our last one, we have negative log again. So we're gonna plug that in, hit 6.0, and we're gonna do times 10 to the negative 12th. We're gonna end parentheses, and now we have our value. So now currently we have 11.22. So we want two decimal places. So we are gonna write 11.22 as our answer, okay? So this is how you go from concentration to pH. Now, what about going backwards? Can you do that too? Let's take a look. So when it comes to canceling a function, this is the same idea as like multiplying versus dividing, or if you have something that's squared and then you square root it to cancel. Well, in terms of logs, we have an anti-log in order to cancel it. Now, the anti-log is using the base, so whatever value that is. Now, being for us, we're assuming that this is as 10, to a power, right? So whenever we have negative log, we just use 10 to the negative pH to cancel that out. Now, how exactly do we use that with our calculator? Well, that's a little bit simpler to use. So when it comes to the TI-36, so the calculator we're using here, you have a couple of different options for how to cancel out your values, and I'll show both of them. There is a button that's designed for this, and I don't think that the creators of this calculator really put it in the best location. It's close, but it's not how like the graphing calculators do. Many of those will actually show you'll have a second button on your calculator, and it's generally the function that's the second button is how you can cancel out all the functions on your calculator. It's actually really nice. So let's take a look at exactly where that is and how we'll do that. So if I put my calculator back on right now, so if we see the log button, which is right here on the top, so you'll see right below it is that here is this E button and then the power of 10. These are the opposites of natural log, which is the E function, and then 10 to the power. So you could just hit this button twice to get 10 to the power of your pH. Now, the other way you can do it is you could simply just type in 10 and then put your power button and then plug it in this way as well. That's usually the easier way because probably 99% of students are used to using that already when it comes to their functions. Let's do a couple examples together and then we'll be on our way. So let's find our theoretical H plus concentration based on our pH values. So we're going to use the antilog to do that. So the thing here is the sig figs are based on the number of decimal places you have. So like on the first example, right, we have two decimals. So that means that your concentration is going to be two sig figs as well when we calculate that. So sig figs are always important, especially if you have to record them digitally in a lot of your homeworks and labs. So let's take a look. Let's use our calculator to actually do this. So if I bring up my calculator, so before I still have the 10 function here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the negative sign. So that's really important, or you're going to get a value that doesn't make any sense. Then we'll put 7.40. So we put that whole value in, and then all we have to do is hit equals. And now what this shows you is how small your value is. So what we have is our four value, and being that's going to be 4.0, then we just got to move that to a power, which we got to count how many spots does this move. Now, if you're lucky, maybe your calculator has how many spots that's going to move. But for me, I always go the old fashioned way. So we're going to count. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spots. So we have 4.0 times 10 to the negative 8 is our first value. Let's go into another. So the next one, we have 3.2. So what we are going to do is I'll show you how to use the other way. So we're going to do the 10 button. So we're going to hit that twice to make sure it says 10. And now what we'll do is we'll raise that to 3.52. We'll hit equal. And now we have our new number here. So being that we had two decimal places, we need two sig figs. So we are going to say 3.0 times 10. And we need to count how many spots. So we have that. That's four positions that moves. So it's going to be 3.0 times 10 to the negative 4. And remember, these represent molarities is what these shows. So remember your units. Your professors expect it. Now for the next part, right? So one more. So if I do the next one, so let's clear our work. And now we have 10. And we're going to raise that to the power. And we're going to say 12.240. We'll hit equals, and now we have a very, very big number. Now, why is it so large? Have I forgotten anything while doing this? Notice I forgot my negative sign, right? These should be small concentrations. They shouldn't be anything that's massive, right? 10 to the 12th molarity isn't feasible. So let's fix that. So what we'll do is I'll hit my 10 again. I'll raise that to essentially the power in order to fix that. So let's do that. And now we got to hit our negative 12.240. Okay. So now when I change that, we kind of see how different the values are, right? One was 10 to the 12th. This one's 10 to the negative 13th. It's supposed to be tiny. So especially when you have a high pH, it should be very small. So when we do this, right, we have three decimal places. So we'll have three sig figs. So we're going to have 5.75. And then we're going to hit 10 to the negative 13. Molarity will be our answer. And let me move that over so you can see the whole thing. And that would be how you would convert that. Okay. So this has been my demonstration on how to show this with logs. I hope you kind of liked this, something different using my calculator for once. Let me know if this made sense to you and if this helped. And if you do need any help, just reach out to me. You can just send me a message or comment below. If this is your first time here, please hit that like and subscribe button. And if you need more help with math, I have an entire math playlist, which I would highly recommend to help you with chemistry. I know math is really scary, but my goal is to try to make it a little less scary. All right. I hope this helped, and I hope to see you again in the future. Bye now.